Don't know why I've agreed to this, but Angela Bishop is my next guest, which delights me, of course. Angela, good morning to you.
Hi.
And I've agreed to Angela doing an interview, so I'm all yours.
Thank you very much. First of all, many happy returns.
Thank you, Angela.
You're just 30 and 360 months. How does that feel?
Oh, that sounds a much better way of saying
it. It is. You can use that if you
like.
Yes. Now, I've been doing all sorts of research on you, and you started working at 11 years of age. Why so late?
I was going to do comedy. I started because, in actual fact, the true story is my dad died in May of 1950, a very young man, and I didn't know him all that well because of the war years he was away. And Mum has told me that I was a pretty upset boy, and she found something for me to fill in the time. In front of the trams. I joined the Boy Scouts, and there was a radio program called Scouting Around. That got me to 3XY Studios. I fell in love with radio, and at 11 I started doing plays and radio programs and things.
And obviously it fell in love with you too. 49 years, looking back over a career of that duration, can you tell me, I love a bit of gossip, you might have learned, is there a secret you've heard, something you've seen that you've managed to keep secret all that time?
Well, let's have a think.
Graham Kennedy, the years working with him, it was an amazing partnership, and partnerships are, I think, a little like a marriage. You have a lot of really good times, and then there are some times when it all might get a little hairy. Did you two ever have a huge blue?
Probably did at some stage of the game, but nothing which lasted forever, and if it did happen, it happened probably only once or twice. Remembering, of course, that he and I were friends before television came in. We were friends from the early 50s, and I have the highest admiration for Graham now, did then, and right throughout the career. And it really, probably unlike Don, Graham and I knew each other very well personally and socially, so there was nothing he could lie to me about and vice versa. And I still hold him as one of my dearest friends. Of course, distance now keeps us apart because he's living on the farm very happily, and I'm doing this concert, but someone says the name of Graham Kennedy and I get a warm feeling.
One of my happiest Logies moments was this year when you paid tribute to him and you got a wonderful standing ovation when he came out. It was a beautiful moment. Why is it, do you think, he walked away from it all, and have you ever felt like walking away from it all?
Graham wouldn't mind me explaining that Graham is a very nervous performer, always has been, and he goes through absolute hell before he does what he does best, and that is live television. And I think simply he just had enough. He's never said this, but I think about Graham Kennedy and the reason that he gave it away, maybe simply because what else was there for him to prove? I mean, he proved himself as a fine actor, wonderful Tonight Show host, panel show compere. But I suppose this, you know, I mean, it was just a time when he isn't this supposed to be about me?
Yes,
no.
That's right.
And I think that's the reason. But if he were to come back, I know in my heart of hearts that he'd still grab the medium by the throat and do wonderful things with it.
That was the second part of my question. You obviously don't have that same sort of nervousness. You've never felt that desire to just walk away from it all.
No, I'm a different type of performer to Graham. I think one of the reasons why, I mean, the obvious reason that you stay in so long is that there is someone there, whether it be a managing director of a network or enough advertising clients who want you to be in that job. But I think from my side of the fence, one of the important things is I still feel today, as I felt at 11 years of age at 3XY, that I like the industry and I like what I'm doing. Bad days, of course, and they come quite regularly, as they do in every job, but I wouldn't have it any other way. And also, I've got to do a plug for this show. I couldn't be happier in doing anything in television than I am in doing GMA. It suits me, and obviously I suit it.
Definitely you do. The days with Don, they're happy memories, I know. I remember I used to have to beg Mum to let my sister and I stab, and let me tell you, she practiced running the Defence Forces on us when we were children. She got a few little techniques there. And it was tremendous teamwork to watch. Do you think the day of the Tonight Show has passed in Australia, of the National Tonight Show, really?
No, I think it could come back with the right person, and that's the key element always. It doesn't matter, you can get the best producers, the best directors in the world, the best music in the world. If you haven't got the right person sitting there, you're not going to succeed. The years with Don were great, primarily because they came about by accident. I was about to leave Nine because I'd finished my stint with Graham. He asked for me, and I didn't know Don all that well. As a matter of fact, I think the first line I used on the Don Lane show at the wheel was "Go home, Yank," you know, way. But then came into my life a very special time with Don Lane. He's the most delightful person to work with. He is so generous, and he's got that terrific attitude, which I hope I have too. It doesn't matter who's getting the laugh, so long as it's there. So I've been blessed with two wonderful partnerships, and I consider this to be a third partnership, so you'd never hear me complaining about that sort of thing.
It's fantastic. I know one other thing you're very interested in is politics. You've interviewed so many very powerful politicians. Have you ever considered, ever, at one stage, at some stage,
Many years ago, but I wouldn't do it now.
I'm saying forget Bert for the Logies, we want Bert for PM.
I don't think there'd be too many people who'd actually, put their name up now, would they, for PM? It's the most difficult
job. It is difficult.
And who can stand the scrutiny?
But what would you say to people, what would you say to Australians if you were out there?
Here's Susie. We're out of time. Thank you, Angela.
Thank you, Bert. That was
great fun. Good on you. The most unusual feeling on your own show, and I'll tell you what, I'm so pleased they chose you because you're just, and congratulations on
Thank
the panel.
You.
It's terrific. Sometimes I'm in tears watching you because you're so good.